called He Loves Me Not. My 5-year-old son doesn't love me. I know this because he tells me so on a regular basis. Mornings, I stand on the threshold of the open door as he races out into the cool morning, and I utter the ritual phrase of mothers everywhere. He smiles, but says nothing in return. Some days, when he and his sister are bolting out the door into their father's waiting car, I bend to kiss him goodbye. He steadies his smooth cheek against mine, accepting my affection, but he does not reciprocate. At bedtime, he says, I like you. But do you love me? I press, trying not to take his slight personally. Do you love Daddy? Not really, he shrugs. Sometimes, after a moment, he reconsiders. I love you a little lot. What does that mean? It just means that I like you. I like you a little lot. And that is all I get. Liking me a little lot may mean that he likes me just a little bit, or that he likes me less than a lot, or maybe a lot more than a little. I'm pretty sure it doesn't mean that he likes me a lot, and I know for certain that he does not think that he loves me, at least not in his own correlation of words to feelings. This is in direct contrast to his 8-year-old sister, who screams, I hate you. And by this, of course, I know that she cannot live without me. It's not that Finley's emotions are shallow. He's steadfast and devoted to the objects of his affection. The cardboard boxes for every Lego set he has ever received live in a jumble of important materials under his bed. Every once in a while, I fish out a used lollipop stick or a disposable coffee lid. He saves every postcard, sticker, and piece of plastic junk from every birthday party we've ever attended. Strings and loose beads are positively talismanic. Nor is Finn fickle. He had the strength of character to refuse all non-white food for a year. He has the patience and devotion to sit patiently in the pre-dawn hallway until the crack of light under his sister's door signals that she is awake. Nor is the problem that he's compromised in his verbal ability. He accurately evaluates mediocre picture books as goodish baddish. So when he tells me he doesn't love me, I have to believe him. He is a boy who knows his own heart. It's not that he can't love. In those dim moments in his bedroom, he admits that there are things with great claim on his affections. Mostly, those things would be Lego. It's really hard, he tells me when I question him. I just love Lego so much. And then he buries his head in his blanket, overcome not with guilt, but with the tactile memory of his beloved bricks. And this is what gets to me. My son is a passionate, affectionate, enthusiastic child. There are many things that he loves and for which he vociferously proclaims his love. Matchbox cars, rockets, certain video games, my iPhone, Captain Underpants, The Last Airbender, gymnastics, Indiana Jones, a sassy smart girl in his school to whom he writes passionate BFF notes with his sister's help. He loves digging in the sand with his best friend. He loves rice, dirt, swimming, apples, anything that involves a ball or throwing himself off of great heights. And once, mired in dust, grading a long dirt road for their trucks in the park, he turned to his best friend, a boy as sweet and tough as they come, and said, I wish I were you. Later, he told me, I just really love Ian. I want to be like him. And there it was, that word, uttered in unabashed sincerity, just not to me. There are signs that deep down, my son and I do have a future together. Unlike his sister, whose independence is fierce and prideful, and sometimes her downfall, my son relies on me with an easy, disarming grace. He accepts my company and my help, and when he asks me to leave him alone to play, he does so respectfully, as if he's afraid to hurt my feelings. He's the child whose small hand reaches unthinkingly for mine when we cross a street, who walks hand in hand, block after block, unselfconscious of the fact that he is with his mother. Even on the way to kindergarten, his smallish, biggish hand curls into mine until we reach the blacktop, and then he races to join his friends, the necessary but nearly empty red backpack swaying against him. He is the child who climbs into my bed on a cold morning to curl the still warm skein of his body into the curve of my own, He lies still against me in the afternoon quiet, telling me about his friends. He will run at full speed and jump into my arms when I pick him up from school like a sailor on shore leave. He seeks me out first when he is hurt in any way. He craves touch, even my imperfect, smelly, awkward touch. He loves me. He loves me not. He must love me. He does, in fact, love me. He does not know he loves me. My son believes now in passion. He believes in those things that grab you by the throat, roil your gut, make your eyes shine and your pulse race. He loves the things that make you shake and forget to eat. For him, excitement is love. Pure pleasure is love. Mastery is love. And yes, these things are necessary, even central to life, but they may not be the same thing as love. So how can I teach him that those other things, the abiding calm, the deep sense of safety, the smoldering comfort that he knows with me or his father or his sister, is another part of love's beating heart? Of course, I can't. I can only stand by him and wait like a steadfast soldier, hoping not to be drowned in the rush of his life. There is nothing else to do because my son is exactly like the rest of us. Already, he knows his own heart almost.
Yeah.